Now please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please join me in prayer. Father, thank you for allowing us to celebrate all of our accomplishments here tonight. Thank you for the chance to gather as we honor our graduating class. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to attend Bryan Collegiate High School, to have an unforgettable educational experience, make lifelong friendships, and lasting memories. I ask you to bless this graduating class and be here with us tonight as we recognize our achievement. I also ask that you bless our teachers and administrators who have played such a large part in our high school experience. Father, we are so grateful for the families that are here represented here tonight, families that have supported and cheered us on throughout our high school journey. Tonight, we pray for those who will be continuing their education, that you would help them use discernment and decision-making, the knowledge to succeed, and the wisdom to know that success has many different definitions. For those going into the workforce, we pray you give the sense of what is right and just and the wisdom to resolve conflicts that may arise. We pray for the protection for those going into the armed forces. May they serve our country with courage and integrity. We pray for every graduate and family here tonight that they would find reward and joy in their life's calling and contribute to their communities in a meaningful way. Amen. You may now be seated. Please join me in welcoming our principal, Mr. Tommy Roberts.
Good evening. I am Tommy Roberts, and I have the privilege of serving as principal at Bryan Collegiate High School. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Bryan Independent School District, our administration, faculty, staff, honored guests, and on behalf of the students and soon-to-be graduates, it is my honor to welcome you here tonight. Graduates, I have had the privilege of watching you grow and mature into young adults, and I'm so proud of all that you have accomplished. Tonight is the representation of your accomplishments. You have earned, as a class, over 4,000 college credit hours. Yeah. With an average of 51 hours each. 10 of you here tonight have gone above and beyond what was required of you and earned your associate's degree from Blinn College. Between all of you, you've earned over 250 college acceptances, and you have served over 11,000 community service hours in our local community that has given you so much. In the fall, this community will continue to support many of you in your educational endeavors. If you are the recipient of a local scholarship or a scholarship from the Bryan ISD Educational Foundation, please stand at this time and be recognized. You may be seated. I also want to take this moment to recognize those students who are the first in their families to attend college and those that are the first in their families to graduate from high school. Graduates, you are setting a new standard in your family by making education a focus in your life. Thank you for being a great role model so that other family members can follow your example. If you are the first in your family to graduate from high school or the first to ever attend college, please stand tonight and be recognized. Thank you. I will now begin with the introductions of guests on our stage. Please hold all applause until we are done with all introductions. And please stand when I call your name. Dr. Christy Whitbeck, Superintendent of Bryan ISD Schools. Mr. Mark McCall, Board President. Dr. Julie Harlan, Board Vice President. Mrs. Felicia Benford, Board Secretary. Mrs. Fran Duane, Board Member. Mr. David Stasny, Board Member. Mrs. Ruthie Waller, Board Member. Dr. Douglas Warnerberger, Board Member. Mrs. Dana Beechuk, Bryan Collegiate High School Associate Principal. Mrs. Albany Moon, Name Announcer. Jesus Vega Tirado, Senior Class President. Andrea Conejo, Senior Class Valedictorian. Melanie Sanchez, Senior Class Representative. Danae Coachman, Senior Class Representative. Also joining us tonight, Mrs. Ginger Carabine, Bryan ISD Chief of Staff. Dr. Barbara Yabar, Associate Superintendent of Teaching and Learning. Mr. Kevin Besall, Assistant Superintendent of Business Services. Mrs. Donna Willett, Director of Counseling Services. Mrs. Sheila Holmeyer, Bryan Collegiate Academic Advisor. Mrs. Jan McCall, Bryan Collegiate Academic Advisor. Mr. Eric Tolhurst, Keynote Speaker. Mrs. Cecilia Dominguez, Principal Secretary. And Ms. Lucy Villarreal, Bryan Collegiate Registrar. Let's give these guys a round of applause. I would also like to take this time to recognize a group of world-class educators that choose each and every day to do what is right and best for kids. If you are a current or former staff member of Bryan Collegiate High School, please stand and be recognized for your unwavering commitment in helping these seniors achieve what they have been doing for the last 4 years. Now help me welcome Senior Class President of Bryan Collegiate High School, Jesus Vega Tirado.
Good evening. And welcome to Bryan Collegiate's Class of 2020 graduation ceremony. I'm Jesus Vega Tirado, Senior Class President. Buenas tardes y bienvenidos a la graduación de la clase del 2020 de Bryan Collegiate. Yo soy Jesus Vega Tirado, el presidente de la clase. As you know, tonight is an important milestone, and for many, a rite of passage. It is amazing that we are able to have this in person while social distancing, rather than virtually. Graduation is not only a celebration to the end of our high school journey, it is also a new beginning. Now more than ever, as we are not only graduating high school, we are doing so in the midst of a global pandemic and a global social movement. I do not think any of us imagine ending school online and having graduation at a football stadium. Firstly, I want to take some time to thank and acknowledge everyone here tonight, whether you are here in the stands, in person, or at home, watching, cheering on your seniors. Primeramente, quiero darles las gracias y reconocer a todos quienes están aquí presentes en el estadio
o viendo en casa, celebrando a sus graduandos de esta noche.
From parents to siblings to friends and many others who have helped push us to get to where we are today, whether it be through positive encouragement or tough love, thank you. We could not have reached this point without your support.
Padres, hermanos, amigos, y todos que nos han ayudado a llegar donde estamos hoy, gracias. No podríamos haber llegado a este punto sin la ayuda de todos ustedes.
Like many of you, I did not think we would be able to have an in-person graduation. I am so thrilled to be able to walk up those steps and stand here before you.
Only a few short years ago, we were interviewing to be students at Bryan Collegiate. I seem to recall us being a shy and timid bunch. Look at us now. We are on the verge of conquering the world. Without a doubt, attending Bryan Collegiate was one of the best paths we could have chosen. Bryan Collegiate has helped us understand our full potential and pushed us towards a better future.
Can we get a round of applause for our wonderful Collegiate staff and teachers who have given us unwavering support through the 4 years?
Side note, all the teachers and staff deserve a raise. At Collegiate, we learn how to communicate with one another, build meaningful relationships, and contribute to society through service and leadership. We learn not only how to format and write our thoughts onto paper, but also how to express those thoughts and opinions with one another in a respectful way. We learn to be open-minded, autonomous, and helpful, not only while at school, but while volunteering, at work, and at home. To my fellow classmates, I want to say congratulations. All our tenacity has paid off, and you should be proud of yourselves. Please know that you matter and you are important. I know there were times when it seemed like graduation would never come. The countless headaches, tears, and high stress levels were all worth it. Now, as we begin the next stage of our journey, I would like to share some words from Dr. Dennis Carroll, who is a pandemic expert, as I find his words apply on many levels. All things must pass, and to avoid the worst consequences of change, we are going to have to change the way we live on this planet. If we do not, then we are going to pay a severe price. So class of 2020, what will you do? Who will you be? Will you become complacent with the many injustices that are taking place all around us? Here's my advice. Look at the injustices going on all around us and do not conform to the status quo. There are many social issues impacting our lives and those around us. Black Lives Matter, the Me Too movement, immigration reform, the gender pay gap, the lack of healthcare, the list goes on and on. Choose one, choose two, choose them all, and put up a lifelong fight against those injustices. No matter your race, ethnicity, gender, or sexual orientation, you are more than capable of fighting against injustice and bringing about positive change in our local community and on a larger scale, our world. I say this to you, class of 2020. I wish you each the best. Strive for personal success and happiness while also striving to make this world a better place for everyone. And remember to vote in every election. Thank you and enjoy the ceremony. Gracias y disfruten la ceremonia.
On behalf of the senior class of 2020, on this day, June 25th, we are presenting the school and student body with new signs. These new signs will proudly be displayed in front of our building and emphasize the Bryan Collegiate logo, always growing, always learning, and always serving.
We are delighted to accept this class gift on behalf of the underclassmen and staff of Bryan Collegiate High School. We wish the senior class of 2020 the best of luck in your future endeavors.
You have left us with many memories that we will treasure forever in our hearts. Congratulations on your accomplishments, and thank you for this gift.
In 2009, Bryan Collegiate's inaugural class was challenged with the task of memorizing and reciting Rudyard Kipling's poem, If. Now the assignment serves as a rite of passage and a tradition that connects all Bryan Collegiate graduates. When Mark Douglas, was former Bryan Collegiate teacher, was asked why he selected this assignment for the students of Bryan Collegiate, here is some of what he had to say. To memorize If by Kipling is itself an act of perseverance. You all had to focus your will, grit your teeth, and sigh in frustration to get to that final recitation moment endured with sweaty palms. We know many students at Collegiate have memorized it before you. Many of those recitations were not perfect, but they made it through. This is a poem about making it through, and so it is altogether fitting for a high school graduation. Every line is a truism, a kernel of wisdom that has somehow survived the fires and quaking of time. I wanted my students to move the words around in their mouths and pack them into their memory. I hope the poem would become more to them than an assignment. I truly hope the poem sticks with you, that it lasts longer than your yearbook. The poem represents life as we know it. You and I, we dare to do great things, and every one of us will face outrageous opposition, significant challenge, and impossible odds. This poem is a gift from another age that reminds you to fill the unforgiving minutes of your life with 60 seconds worth of distance run. Fill it up, pull everything you can out of the minutes and years. Life is shorter than you can possibly imagine at your young age. The people are more precious, the victories are rare, so enjoy them deeply. Be sure to tell the people around you, thank you, for their investment in your life. You wouldn't be who you are without their labors. You went to a special high school in a special town where they asked you to do unusual things like memorize old poems by fussy old men who believe you will have many glories ahead of you. Tell your will to hold on and ask people with gray hair for their insight and counsel. Will the top 10% honor graduates please make your way to the stage? And now, the reading of Rudyard Kipling's poem, If. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet don't look too good nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose and start again at your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your long after they are gone. And so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you. If all men count with you, but none too much. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run. Yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And, which is more, you'll be a man, my son.
Congratulations, graduates, for all that you have accomplished during the last 4 years. I am so very proud of each and every one of you. At this time, we will recognize those students who are the Class of 2020 Honor Graduates. The Class of 2020 Honor Graduates are Abigail Ponce. Abigail will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.7818 GPA. Aaron Joel Collier. Aaron will attend the University of Texas at Tyler this fall with a 4.827 grade point J. Caitlin Maria Pierce. Caitlin will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.8275 grade point average. Danae Lexi Coachman. Danae will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.9558 grade point average. Matthew Thomas Berry. Matthew will attend the University of Illinois at Chicago this fall with a 4.9654 grade point average. Jesus Vega Tirado. Jesus will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.9725 grade point average. The Class of 2020 Salutatorian, Sage Ariana Vantine. Sage will attain St. Mary's University this fall with a 4.9978 grade point average. And the Class of 2020 Valedictorian, Andrea Anihi Conejo. Andrea will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 5.102 grade point average.
All right. Good evening, everybody. Hope everyone's doing well. I'm genuinely happy to see all of us together again after so long. I wish the circumstances were different, but we were dealt super sour lemons and are trying to make sweet lemonade. As we all know, we left school this year for spring break, not knowing it would be our last time on campus. You may have felt like your life was put on hold. Everything was full of uncertainty, and you weren't sure if there would even be a graduation. We were all here. Here we are, despite everything that was thrown our way. Today, we celebrate an important milestone. It is the day that we get to say that we officially finished high school and are ready to embark onto the next journey in our lives. The world will forever remember the Class of 2020 as the class that graduated during the coronavirus pandemic. However, we should strive to change that title. We should strive to be known as the best class that will change the world for the better. We are unstoppable. So many things have happened throughout our lives, but we overcame every obstacle that was put in our paths. But apparently, we like challenges. I mean, we literally signed up for college right after middle school. Like, what were we thinking? But here we are, with each of us having an average of 50 college credit hours. We are so unstoppable that not even a worldwide pandemic could stop us from having a graduation ceremony. I used to laugh at the people that told me that 4 years of high school will pass by in a flash. As a 14-year-old, 4 years seemed like an eternity. And now I understand what they meant. It really doesn't feel like 4 years have passed. It seems like just yesterday we were being interviewed by BCHS staff. A lot of memories and friends were made in that small building that we call Bryan Collegiate High School. There are many times when people are caught up in the past or the future, but neglect the present. We can't change the past and we can't predict the future. The present is the only thing that is guaranteed. With that being said, I want you all to take the time to appreciate the people that you have helped, that have helped you get to where you are right now. Whether it's your teachers, parents, friends, or even yourself. I personally would like to thank my family. To my mom and little brother, thank you for forcing me to do my homework when I was feeling lazy, and for making me laugh when I was feeling down. I love you guys. Dad, I regret being embarrassed in elementary school of you showing up to school in your mechanic uniform just because it was dirty. I regret getting mad at you for not buying me the newest clothes or phone just because I wanted to be like the other kids. I regret hating you for being absent for a large portion of my life because you were always busy working. Now that I am an adult, I understand the sacrifices you made for me. You just wanted us to have a better life. I'm sorry that it took me so long to figure that out. I wish I could go back in time and change the way I treated you, but that's currently impossible. All I can do now is tell you this. I appreciate you working all day in the hot sun to be able to provide a roof over my head and food on the table. Without you, I wouldn't be here today. Thank you for being the best dad that I could have ever asked for. I love you, Dad. Personalmente, me gustaría agradecer a mi familia, a mi madre y mi hermanito. Gracias por obligarme a hacer mi tarea cuando me sentía floja o por hacerme reír cuando me sentía triste. Los amo. Papá, lamento estar avergonzado en la escuela primaria de que te presentaras a la escuela con tu uniforme mecánico solo porque estaba sucio. Lamento enojarme contigo por no comprarme la ropa o el teléfono más nuevo solo porque quería ser como los otros niños. Lamento odiarte por estar ausente durante gran parte de mi vida porque siempre estabas ocupado trabajando. Ahora que soy una adulta, entiendo los sacrificios que hiciste por mí. Solo querías que tuviéramos una vida mejor. Lamento que me haya tomado tanto tiempo para darme cuenta. Desearía poder retroceder el tiempo y cambiar la forma en que te trataste. Pero ahorita eso es imposible. Todo lo que puedo hacer ahorita es decirte esto. Te agradezco que trabajes todo el día bajo el sol para poner un techo sobre mi cabeza y comida en la mesa. Sin ti, no estaría aquí hoy. Gracias por ser el mejor padre que podría haber pedido. Te amo, papá. Years from now, maybe in the next couple of weeks, most of you will forget what was said here today. You will also forget what happened, who spoke, what did you wear? But something I'm sure a lot of you will remember is how it felt to be here today. Maybe you feel scared, feeling unprepared for what comes next. You might be excited about all the new opportunities you will have, the beginning of a whole new chapter in your life. Many of y'all are first generation students such as myself, so just making it this far is an achievement on its own, but you're hungry for more. You don't want to stop here. You want to see what the next journey brings. I'm here to remind you that no matter what comes next, if it's going to community college, university, or starting a job, you will achieve great things. Thank you.
As we embark on our journey in life, let us reflect on all the memories we created together at Bryan Collegiate. Let's take a trip down memory lane, starting all the way back to freshman year. Remember when we had to take Cornell notes and quickly grew to dislike them? But then later on, we realized how helpful they were in our college classes. Let's not forget about Mr. Rushaw's epic Kahoot and Quizlet Live competitions. Looking back, it's funny how those Dr. Seuss stories Mr. Rushaw read to us were just as relevant to us as 15-year-olds as they were when we were only five. One of my favorite personal memories from freshman year was starting the birthday cake traditions with my friends. For everyone's birthday, we bake the cake for each other and then try to sneak it into the school. But sadly, Mr. Roberts caught us every single time. Much to Mr. Roberts' dismay, 4 years later, we were still baking cakes. I know we all remember the last day of freshman year. That was the day we were to get sorted into our families. Competed with them in the Olympics for the first time. We never realized at the time our family would play such an important role in our lives. And for many of us, families are where we made some of our best friends and learned to be leaders. Now on to sophomore year. I remember Miss Wilde and Mr. Persine's cheesy puns, but sometimes they were not that punny, pun intended. Also, do you remember when our professor, Mr. Overstreet, better known as Todd, brought his pet lizard to class? I sure do, because I was terrified of the little thing. Sophomore year was also the year that the cheer team formed, and it was one of the most memorable and fun experiences I had at Collegiate. Next is good old junior year. This was the first year for us to go to Blinn. We were all excited and nervous all at once. Some of us drove to the Blinn campus and may have received a parking ticket or two. I remember that year, it was a common occurrence to see our peers lined up and down the hallway reciting the words to the If poem, so we can memorize it perfectly and then sign our names on the wall of fame. Let's not forget the struggle of AP Physics and junior service project. If only we had volunteered during the summer like our PCC teachers told us to do. If there are any soon-to-be juniors out there, do your 30 hours for junior service project during the summer. It really makes a difference. And finally, as the junior class cast council, we planned a pretty awesome prom, if I may say so myself. Lastly is senior year, one of the most fun yet tragic and memorable years we have had at Collegiate. Let's start with all the good times we had in this very short year. The kickball tournament was one of the most competitive and entertaining events at Collegiate, other than soccer, of course. My favorite memory of senior year, other than getting an extended spring break, was planning and attending homecoming with my classmates. I remember our class of 2020 having our senior year taken away from us because of COVID-19. As hard as it has been, the shared experience has made us stronger and closer together. We showed everyone that we can persevere no matter the struggles we face. We are the class of 2020, one of the most memorable classes to have ever walked the halls of Bryan Collegiate. Let's remember the last 4 years together. Let's remember today. And most importantly, remember if we can survive the aftermath of 9/11, AP physics, and coronavirus, then we can for sure survive college.
I have the distinct pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker for the evening. He is a world-class educator and has been a respected member of the Bryan Collegiate faculty since the fall of 2016. The senior class requested that he speak here tonight and has been a significant part of their journey at Bryan Collegiate. Please help me in welcoming Mr. Eric Tolhurst.
Good evening. We are here today to celebrate the class of 2020 and their graduation from Bryan Collegiate High School. Before I begin, I want to thank all of the parents for supporting our students over the past 4 years. These students have made it this far because you were and are there to support them at home, whether that is enforcing homework times, keeping them off their phones, driving them to school, driving them to practices, being a shoulder to cry on, letting students vent about their professors at Blinn, and much more. So I ask the students, please give a round of applause to your parents and loved ones in the audience. This class of 2020 is very special to me. It was my first freshman class and my first overall at Bryan Collegiate. It is also the class that convinced me to stay in the educational field and that teaching was the path I wanted to stay on. Many of you I taught for your freshman and sophomore years. 2 years full of joy, fun, Socratic seminars, timed writings, and trying to keep track of who hasn't turned their essays in yet. Those who I didn't teach were well taken care of by Mrs. Anthony and Ms. Denshaw. Now, I always started class with a very specific activity. Do you all remember what that activity was? Good things. I heard a couple out there. It's only been a couple years. Good things is an activity that lets us share the little or big things in our lives that we feel good about with those around us. And every class period, I expected at least 4 students to share good things. I learned so much about each of you as you shared your good things, from visiting family, seeing an old friend, getting your first job, and getting a good grade in anthropology. I also wanted to thank one specific place in particular for providing so much joy to y'all. So thank you, Wings and More. You brought joy to at least one student per class per day. This brings me to the message of my speech tonight. Encourage those around you to keep on sharing good things. You are embarking on a long road, and that road will have bumps and potholes and pitfalls, and it will not treat you kindly or fairly at times. But recognizing out loud, the things that you have achieved or made you happy can help you through difficult times by giving you a sense of balance to life. That there are things that you can do, that you can make positive changes, that you can smile, that good things do happen. Your class has already been through so much this year, and the road is already rocky ahead of you. But I believe that won't stop you from doing wonderful things and enjoying what you have or will have in the future. So please share with your family, your friends, your loved ones, and yes, even your professors at college who really need to hear good things sometimes, especially after essay turn-ins. I not only want you to keep sharing your good things with others, I want you to start listening to others' good things the same way I and the teachers at BCHS listen to yours. I can tell you personally that listening to other good things can bring so much joy, if not more, to your day. When your acceptances started coming in, some of you came by my classroom to tell me good news, and the looks on your face and the excitement in your words as you told me where you got a letter from, you better believe that my good thing at Friday Teacher PD was how happy y'all were to get accepted and how excited I was to see you all growing up. So make sure to listen, because sometimes someone else's good thing can be the hop in your step that you need for the day. In the end, this class has forever changed my life, and I will forever remember you. It has been my greatest honor to be a part of your lives, and I sincerely hope that each of you will go on to be the best person you can be. Class of 2020, I and all of the teachers at BCHS wish you the very best. Congratulations.
Dr. Whitbeck, I am pleased to present the Bryan Collegiate High School class of 2020. The academic advisors and I have examined the records of each and every one of these candidates, and we have found that each of these students has completed the necessary requirements set forth by the Bryan Independent School District and are eligible to participate in these commencement exercises. Additionally, I am pleased to announce that we have 10 students who have completed the required course of study and are also candidates for their associate's degrees at Bland College.
Thank you, Mr. Roberts. As the superintendent of the Bryan Independent School District, it is my honor to certify that these graduates before us, the Bryan Collegiate Class of 2020, are hereby eligible for the commencement exercises. That means you're official. Okay. So, students, before you come forward on the stage, I want to take just a moment. This is a very unconventional graduation in our district, and it's a little unusual for me to stop and be thankful, but we need to do that. There were many options, a virtual graduation, a drive-by, but no, we made a real graduation happen, and it is because of so many wonderful staff members, and many of them are here tonight. So wherever you are, raise your hand or stand up if you helped us give these graduates a real graduation. We want to thank you. And lastly, as you go forward, you will receive a packet with a lot of important information in it. And a gift from Bryan ISD as we give you a bookmark of our Essential Eight. So, as you heard Jesus tonight, he challenged you. I challenge you also to follow the traits of the Essential Eight. Be the kindest and most tolerant person you know. Always have a grateful heart and never stop giving back to your community as you have learned. Be optimistic and courageous as you go forward with unexpected challenges. Have the greatest work ethic, and all of those together will make you an amazing leader in your community and most importantly in your home. So we wish you the very best. Go forward with all of your heart and know that Bryan ISD will always be your home and your alma mater. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Whitbeck. At this time, we will begin the presentation of diplomas.
Macy Love Alanis. Macy will attend Sam Houston State University. Joanna Amichali Alfaro Garci Duenas. Joanna will attend Sam Houston State University. Cristian Armando Alvarado. Cristian will attend Stephen F. Austin State University. Luis Carlos Balderas Soto. Luis will attend Texas State Technical College. Matthew Thomas Berry. Matthew will attend the University of Illinois at Chicago. Isaiah Alexander Bass. Isaiah will attend St. Edward's University. Aledis Alondra Bello. Aledis will attend Blinn College. Joshua Israel Bowser. Josh will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Michael Camacho. Michael will attend Texas A&M University. Sitlali Jacqueline Carizales. Sitlali will attend Blinn College. Henry Carvajal. Henry will attend Texas State University. Arleth Zauri Casillas Espinosa. Arleth will attend Texas State University. Hema Alejandra Chaires. Hema will attend the University of Texas at Tyler. Sarah Michelle Cockrell. Sarah will enlist in the U.S. Navy. Aaron Joel Collier. Aaron will attend the University of Texas at Tyler. Andrea Anaid Conejo. Andrea will attend Texas A&M University. Jasmine Lisette Contreras. Jasmine will enlist in the U.S. Army. Lydia Alexis Cordova. Lydia will attend Texas A&M at Galveston. Elena Michelle De Leon. Elena will attend Texas State University. Jocelyn Guadalupe Don Juan Rodriguez. Jocelyn will attend Blinn College. Priscilla Escorza. Priscilla will attend Texas State University. Deborah Judith Faz. Deborah will attend St. Edward's University. Daphne Francisco. Daphne will attend Sam Houston State University. Yasmin Garcia. Yasmin will attend Blinn College. Francisco Javier Garcia. Frank will attend the University of Texas at Tyler. Sabin Joel Garcia. Sabin will attend Blinn College. Jesus Alejandro Garcia Calzoncin. Jesus will attend Blinn College. Kevin Alexis Garcia Rebollar. Kevin will attend Texas A&M University. Navetse Gomez Salazar. Navetse will attend Sam Houston State University. Natalie Nicole Gonzalez. Natalie will attend Sam Houston State University. Jaden Christopher Green. Jaden will attend University of North Texas at Dallas. Crystal Huerta. Crystal will attend Sam Houston State University. Daniel Edward Hunt. Daniel will attend Austin College. Elizabeth Renee Jimenez. Lizzie will attend Stephen F. Austin State University. Arize Juarez Mendez. Arize will attend Texas State University. Danae Lexi Coachman. Danae will attend Texas A&M University. Akayla Janae McCoy. Akayla will attend Howard University. Kevin Angel Messino Campos. Kevin will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Kimon Antoine Miles. Kimon will attend Sam Houston State University. Matthew Leroy Molina Hernandez. Leroy will attend Texas A&M University. Griselda Nieto. Griselda will attend Texas State University. Miriam Juliana Ortega Vega. Miriam will attend Blinn College. Kenya Satine Outley. Kenya will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Jacqueline Renee Phillips. Jackie will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Caitlin Marie Pierce. Caitlin will attend Texas A&M University. Lindsay Ann Pierce. Lindsay will attend Sam Houston State University. Abigail Ponce. Abby will attend Texas A&M University. David Garrett Provazek. David will attend Texas A&M University. Yaira Nayeli Puga. Yaira will attend Blinn College. Cristobal Ramirez. Cristobal will attend Sam Houston State University. Gustavo Angel Moreno Rico. Gustavo will attend Stephen F. Austin State University. Reagan Isabella Ring. Reagan will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Carla Paola Rodriguez. Carla will attend St. Edward's University. Ana Maria Rodriguez Castillo. Ana will attend University of Texas at Arlington. Megan Elizabeth Rose. Megan will attend Sam Houston State University. Bartholomew Salazar Jr. BJ will attend University of Dallas. Marisol Sanchez Calzada. Marisol will attend Blinn College. Jonathan Devin Sanchez. Jonathan will attend University of Texas at Tyler. Melanie Lisette Sanchez. Melanie will attend Texas State University. Xavier Vincent Sanchez. Xavier will attend Blinn College. Kelly Joanna Sanchez Montevallis. Kelly will attend Blinn College. J. Ray Seidler. J. Ray will attend Blinn College. Zachary Joseph Sitton. Zachary will attend Baylor University. Carson Allen Smith. Carson will attend Texas A&M Kingsville. Jennifer Solis. Jennifer will attend Blinn College. Cynthia Marisa Sotelo. Cynthia will attend Sam Houston State University. Corey David Terrell. Corey will attend Texas State University. Vanessa Tirado Mendoza. Vanessa will attend Sam Houston State University. Bjorn Bennett Van Hyke. Bennett will attend Blinn College. Sage Ariana Van Tine. Sage will attend St. Mary's University. Lisa Marie Vargas. Lisa will attend Blinn College. Jesus Vega Tirado. Jesus will attend Texas A&M University. Aiden Jeremiah Villarreal. Aiden will attend Blinn College. Courtney Ann Wall. Courtney will attend Texas A&M University. Raven Arian Jade West. Raven will attend Blinn College. Morgan Thomas Wigington. Morgan will attend Texas State Technical College. Charles James Ibarra. Charlie will attend Sam Houston State University. Jesus Gaspar Zacarias. Jesus will attend the University of Texas at Tyler. Emilio Zambrano Macias. Emilio will attend Texas A&M University. Jennifer Zavala Gomez. Jennifer will attend Blinn College.
Okay, let's hear it one more time for the Bryan Collegiate Class of 2020. Graduates, please stand and remain standing in your row. At this time, please move your tassel. Congratulations, Class of 2020. You may now be seated. And now, if you will direct your attention to the public announcer.
Congratulations, graduates. We are so proud of you and stand beside you in great expectation of your futures. We want to send you off in style, so please direct your attention to the area behind the visitor bleachers. The lights on that side are going to be turned off momentarily. The lights on the home side will remain on throughout the display to ensure everyone's safety. Upon conclusion of the fireworks, graduates and their guests will be dismissed to leave. There will not be a processional off the field or out of the stadium. Again, congratulations to the history-making class of 2020. Now please sit back and enjoy the show.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. I never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye, but yesterday's gone. We gotta keep moving on. I'm so thankful for the moment, so glad I got to know you. The times that we had, I'll keep like a photograph and hold you in my heart forever.
I'm living in that 21st century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it. Screams from the haters. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. Ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. Feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine, just imagine. I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel good creeping up on you, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. There ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the
feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday bed.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. Talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you will find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame, yeah. And the world's gonna know your name, yeah. Cause you wear with the God's face. And the world's gonna know your name. And you'll be on the walls of the Hall of Fame. I did it all. I did it all. I'm only the second this world could give. So many places, the things that I did. I was every broken bone. I swear I lived.
Bryan ISD thanks all the parents, grandparents, relatives, and friends for your help and support that made tonight possible. We are honored to have been able to partner with you and your students for the futures of these young men and women that will undoubtedly change their communities, our state, and nation, and even the world. Graduates, Bryan ISD is your home, and no matter where you go or what you do, we're proud that you're from Bryan, and we love you very much. Good luck, and God bless you all. This concludes the Bryan Collegiate High School graduation ceremony. You are free to leave at your own pace.